Hello everybody, Tegan here with High Point. Today I am excited to bring you a full review of a telescope that is redefining out-of-the-box astrophotography and is quickly becoming the telescope for beginner and advanced astrophotographers alike. This is the Apertura Carbonstar 150mm imaging Newtonian. So like, subscribe, and stay tuned. First and foremost, the Carbonstar 150 is a 150mm imaging Newtonian with a 6-inch primary mirror, and it has a focal length of 600mm, making this a fast F4 system capable of collecting a lot of light in a short amount of time. It's available with or without the dedicated coma corrector, which is also a 0.95 reducer and brings the focal ratio down to an ultra-fast f3.8. This imaging Newtonian was designed with the most popular imaging sensors in mind. That's the ASI 533, the 294, the 183, and the 585. Now, designed may be the wrong word here. Optimized is the better word. To showcase the thought and passion that went into this product, the Apertura team has created an awesome article as to why and how they modernized this imaging Newtonian. I have placed a link in the description below if you want to read more into this. But for now, let's get into the details. Built with CNC machine parts throughout and a full carbon fiber body, the Carbonstar 150 imaging Newtonian is a significant upgrade in construction and build quality when compared to a traditional Newtonian. Everything from the rings to the single piece secondary mirror assembly, the build quality of this telescope delivers a premium feel at an affordable price. Now, the CNC machine secondary here is especially important to me personally. With the secondary design of the Carbonstar, any twisting, flexing, or snapping is going to be completely eliminated. Another frustrating aspect of traditional Newtonians is that on the OTA rings, you will find one mounting hole for your dovetail bar. So when it comes time that you want to install a D-series dovetail, it makes this almost pointless as it adds almost no rigidity to the system. Apertura, on the other hand, has made sure to include both styles of dovetail. By adding both dovetails to the scope, Apertura has made sure that those who want improved stability have access to the D-style dovetail, and those who have a mount that allows only for a Vixen-style dovetail still have access to this imaging Newtonian. Now, in addition to these awesome quality of life improvements, Apertura has also included a new and improved linear bearing focuser with a tight fit draw tube to reduce the tilt in the imaging train. Included as well is an EAF ready focuser base, making installation and use extremely simple. Now, another notable improvement that Apertura has made to the Carbonstar are the addition of internal knife edge baffles that extend from the bottom of the OTA all the way up to the focuser draw tube. These knife edge baffles going all the way up the tube help to mitigate and reduce stray light or off-axis light hitting your primary mirror. This helps increase contrast and reduce local light pollution gradients. You may find that a lot of the traditional Newtonians on the market today have these baffles, but they come up maybe only halfway up the OTA from the mirror, or you may find that they don't have any internal baffling at all. So we have the internal baffles that reduce stray light from the front of the scope, but what about the back of the scope? Now, if you are familiar with imaging Newtonians as I am, you will know that light can leak through the back of the primary mirror cell and provide a beautiful ring of light pollution right in the center of your image. It's actually not beautiful, it's terrible, and you can't get rid of it with flat frames because it is an inconsistent gradient that you can't replicate with flat frames. Now, to completely solve this issue, Apertura has a solution. Apertura has included an insertable backplate that completely covers the primary mirror cell to prevent this kind of light pollution. Yet another very thoughtful idea by Apertura to solve one of the most common problems that we see with the traditional Newtonians on the market today. Now, that must be it as far as quality life improvements and design upgrades and optimization, right? No, Apertura didn't stop here. Now it's time to discuss optical improvements. Earlier, I mentioned that the Carbonstar was optimized for the most popular imaging sensors on the market. Again, the 533, the 294, the 183, and the 585. By optimized, we mean that the Apertura team modeled a number of different secondary mirrors built and tested each one and picked the size which provided the highest signal and best field illumination across these popular imaging sensors. On top of this, Apertura designed this telescope so that the focal plane sits as close to the telescope as possible while still allowing for other third-party accessories to work with this scope. These adjustments result in an increase in signal by 10% at the center when compared to the original Apertura 6-inch imaging Newtonian. And if you include the dedicated 0.95 corrector reducer, then you see an additional 10% increase in signal, giving you a total of 20% increase when compared to the other models. Now, increasing the signal still wasn't enough. By redesigning the body, the Apertura team has standardized a focal point. This means you no longer have to hunt for stars when focusing your telescope. Simply attach your imaging train to the dedicated coma corrector, insert it into your telescope, set it to the 20 millimeter mark, and you'll have very near to precise focus. Now, with all the awesome improvements and the incredible quality of life additions that the Apertura team has added to this imaging Newtonian, the question that stands is, who is this telescope designed for? The answer is, it's designed for everybody. With the weight of this telescope and its carbon fiber tube sitting at only 10.5 pounds, it's compatible with almost any EQ mount on the market, aside from the smallest of star trackers. It carries all the benefits of a large, fast aperture optic without the hassles and the frustrations that come with your traditional imaging Newtonian. Now, be it your first imaging system, be it an upgrade from a smaller refractor that left you wanting more in terms of size and light gathering capacity, or maybe you're even a veteran, you're absolutely going to love this telescope just as I have. And with that, I plan on using it for years to come. Now sit in Zen as I show you several photos that myself and the incredible astrophotography community has taken using this incredible Newtonian.